In the 1790s, France had three status groups called estates. The third estate was mainly made up of peasants, and then it also had city workers and bourgeoisie.
I'm poor.
I'm hungry.
Next up was the second estate. The second estate was mostly made up of nobles, and they owned 20% of land.
I'm the rich and I'm not hungry.
Last, at the top of the list, was the first estate. It consisted mostly of the Roman Catholic clergy. Third estate was the only estate that paid the taxes. The other two did not.
Sorry. We don't pay taxes.
But the third estate was fed up with it.
We want change! Give me liberty or give me...
So the three estates decided to get together to settle this predicament.
You guys need to pay taxes.
No.
The third estate was angry at this and decided to meet somewhere else.
We need a new constitution. We will meet here.
When they were locked out, they met at the indoor tennis court to meet until the constitution was drafted. However, rising prices and hunger helped instigate a revolt at the Bastille. There were always people who wanted the king safe.
Keep the king alive.
But on the other hand, some wanted him executed.
Like me.
Kill the king. Kill the king! Kill the king!
There had then been a decree passed considering Louis XVI to death. Years later, a new interest had sparked. The infamous Napoleon. He was known for his surprise, his lightning speed, and his decisiveness. He received a scholarship to a military school and learned his tactics, and eventually overthrew the Directory and made his new government, the Consulate. Napoleon was a man of enlightenment and believed in reason, but made peace with the church. Napoleon kept the reforms of the French Revolution in the terms of the civil code.
No more newspapers, no more books.
But Napoleon had so much power that he became the consul.
I declare myself Emperor Napoleon I.
And decided to bring 600 men to attack Russia.
Come on, guys, let's go.
After it failed, he was captured and exiled to Elba. But he escaped and recaptured the empire. Napoleon was finally defeated by the Duke of Wellington at Waterloo and was exiled to St. Helens. Where he then died.
Who can say where the road goes?
Unless you use this one, because this one's...
I've been watching you.
Turn it off.